Good evening. This is Pastor Tim West welcoming you to our drive-through presentation of Follow the Star. You will need to press pause at the end of each scene and press play again when you arrive at the next scene. As the first Christmas story unfolds before you, we pray that you will be inspired to make Jesus Christ the center of your Christmas this year. Please press pause now. The story of Christmas begins many centuries before the birth of Jesus with prophecies in the Old Testament concerning his birth. In the Bible, in the book of Isaiah, it speaks of a virgin birth.
Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel.
In Micah, it foretells his birth being in Bethlehem.
But you, Bethlehem, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me, one who will be ruler over Israel.
In Isaiah, it tells of a great impact he will have in the world.
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. And his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
Please press pause now. In the Bible, in the book of Luke, it tells how Mary was told about a special child she would soon have.
God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. And he will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God."
Please press pause now.
The end. The Bible states that Jesus was born in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. We often criticize the innkeeper for turning them away. But if God had wanted them to be inside the inn that night, he would have made it happen. Consider the following. The inn that night was very crowded, and there would not have been a private room because visitors from all over the region had been required to come to Bethlehem for the census. All types of individuals, the good, the bad, and the dangerous, would have been there. They would have been crammed into every available space. We, especially this year, understand how easily disease can spread in an overcrowded room like that. God knew that inside the inn was not the best place for his son to be born. God made sure they were given an area completely away from everyone else where Jesus could be born in privacy and safety. God always takes care of those he loves.
Please press pause now. Jesus is known as the Great Shepherd. So it seems only fitting that his birth would be announced to a group of shepherds first.
and there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in highest heaven, and on earth peace to those with whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord hath told us about."
Please press pause now.
In the Bible it says, "So Joseph went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloth and placed him in a manger." Although Jesus was born in a humble setting, his life has changed the world as no other person has.
He was born in an obscure village, the child of a peasant. He grew up in still another village, where he worked until he was 30. Then for 3 years, he was an itinerant preacher. He never wrote a book. He never held an office. He never had a family or owned a home. He didn't go to college. He never traveled more than 200 miles from the place he was born. He did none of the things one usually associates with greatness. He had no credentials but himself. He was only 33 when public opinion turned against him. His friends ran away. He was turned over to his enemies and went through the mockery of a trial. He was nailed to the cross between two thieves. While he was dying, his executioners gambled for his clothing, the only property he had on earth. When he was dead, he was laid in a borrowed grave through the pity of a friend. 19 centuries have come and gone, and today he is the central figure of the human race, the leader of mankind's progress. All the armies that ever marched, all the navies that ever sailed, all the parliaments that ever sat, all the kings that ever reigned put together, have not affected the life of man on earth as much as that one solitary life.
Thank you for joining us this evening. We pray that you will allow your life to be changed this year by the birth of our Savior Jesus Christ. Merry Christmas to you and your family. God bless.